Congress just snuck a provision in that huge $866 billion National Defense Authorization Bill that is very interesting because it seems to be a direct response to former President Trump. Now, I first told you in this video, the House and the Senate overwhelmingly passed the National Defense Authorization Bill, or NDAA, on a huge bipartisan basis just a few days ago. Now, this bill is thousands of pages long and includes thousands of provisions, so I wasn't able to tell you about every single thing in the bill in that video. But when I was reading through it a little closer, I found something very interesting that caught my eye. A short little paragraph buried on page 959, subtitle H, section 1399AA, a provision that prevents the President of the United States from withdrawing from NATO without a two-thirds vote of the Senate or an act of Congress. The provision was added to the legislation by Senator Tim Kaine of Virginia, a Democrat, and Senator Marco Rubio of Florida, a Republican, and seems to be a direct response to former President Trump's repeated threats, both while he was in office and even on the campaign trail, that the United States should withdraw from NATO or significantly reduce our involvement with NATO. Well, if Trump becomes president again, that's not going to be possible unless he gets a two-thirds majority vote in the Senate or unless there's an act of Congress, which we know is very difficult these days. So it's also worth noting there are multiple mentions of NATO in that NDAA. All of them really reflect the rhetoric that President Biden has been using about the U.S.'s commitment to the NATO alliance and our commitment to standing with Ukraine in the face of its war with Russia. It also makes several mentions of standing with our other NATO allies if their land is ever threatened.